airplanes. We see them everywhere. And if you look above your home, you can usually see one flying in the sky. They come in all shapes and sizes, and people are using them every day, either directly or indirectly. They're used for business travel, vacationing travel, shipping items that we need or want every day, and even for basic viewing entertainment. These days, we even have planes specialized in all sorts of areas, including planes for firefighting, planes for militaristic purposes, planes for launching space shuttles, planes used for performing anti-gravity experiments, and even one specifically designed to transport the President of the United States. But this brings about the question of who do we have to thank for these wondrous and incredibly useful inventions? If this question were asked to any average American citizen, the names of Wilbur and Orville Wright, or more popularly known as the Wright brothers, would undoubtedly come up as the most mentioned name in their answers. However, that wasn't the case when I saw this monument in my community. As a resident of San Jose, California for all of my life, my parents had to drive me down the same road every day to take me to and from both middle and high school. Going on the same path every day, I noticed a monument that I speculated to be a flat, two-dimensional silo with a metal grid pattern and glass to fill in the empty spaces. Directly in front of the monument sat a sign that said Montgomery Hill, and a plaque alongside of it describing the relevance of the monument that I had yet to have the opportunity to read as I cruised past the monument every day. It was only near the end of my middle school career did my father mention to me that the monument was actually an airplane wing sticking perpendicular to the ground. He then added on how the monument and the hill were to commemorate a man named Montgomery and how he had come before the Wright brothers in flying an aircraft. As I passed the monument each day before and after school, I began to question who this Montgomery person was and wonder about his significance to aviation air history in the evergreen community of San Jose. Upon further investigation at the plaque, Montgomery Hill was mentioned to be the site of 55 successful flights for a man named John Joseph Montgomery. Montgomery was said to have discovered the basics of aerodynamics and combined this knowledge with his engineering background as a professor at Santa Clara University to create a heavier-than-air flying machine. Having said all this, the information on the plaque gives rise to the question as to why more people don't know about Montgomery's contribution to aviationary evolution and why the general public only thinks of the Wright brothers when referring to the history of airplane technology. Although one may state that the Colossal Wing is simply a monument to thank and commemorate Montgomery's contributions to aerodynamic developments, Montgomery Hill and the monument undoubtedly serve as reminders of the nation's capitalist mindset and signifies the dishonesty and falsifications that separate the wealthy from the less wealthy. Montgomery Hill was first established as an official historical landmark in 1966. The hill is situated in Evergreen, San Jose, and is located right behind the Evergreen Valley Community College. Around and atop the hill now lies Montgomery Hill Park, an outdoor nature and recreational area with access to over a mile worth of unpaved trails and scenic views. However, John Joseph Montgomery's name did not bear any significance until the late 19th century, and it was not until the early 20th century did his name finally correlate with the east foothills of San Jose. Born in 1858, John Montgomery studied with the high school division at Santa Clara College and later graduated at San Ignatius College with a Bachelor of Arts in Physics, followed with a Master's degree in Physics in 1880. Throughout his time in school, Montgomery was considered somewhat crazy and off for his desire to build a flying machine and his belief that man could be able to fly. Following his college career, Montgomery moved to work in his family's farm in Otay Valley near San Diego, where he continued his interest in flight by observing the wings of geese and devising theories on how the birds' wings were designed to enable lift and flight. By 1883, Montgomery had designed and built a life-size 38-pound glider with aircraft characteristics that surpassed the designs of his peers. He personally tested his glider by having his brother James Montgomery launch the glider by simultaneously running and pulling a rope attached to the glider as John Montgomery sat inside. This can best be shown by the fictional movie Gallant Journey, which was made to honor John Montgomery and his findings. The glider was able to miraculously rise over 15 feet high in the air and traveled up to 600 feet total. Montgomery's strong understanding of physics led him to be the most concerned with the stability and control of his aircraft prior to adding any source of power or motor to his glider, verdict 2017. Thus, Montgomery's first flight in 1883 contained new elements of control and stability such as parabolically curved wings and a stabilizing tailplane. Despite Montgomery's astonishing success in producing a controlled flight, it is even more extraordinary that these aerial technological advancements came 20 years before the Wright brothers' 1903 first flight in Kitty Hawk, North Carolina. With the Wright brothers' first flight coming 20 years after Montgomery's first controlled glider flight, this proposes the question as to what factors led to the fame and wealth of the Wright brothers compared to the disregard of John Montgomery. By 1905, Montgomery made his creation public as he teamed up with a circus performer named Daniel Maloney to lift Montgomery's gliders driven by Maloney 4,000 feet into the air before letting them sail down in controlled circles for about 8 minutes. These performances demonstrated Montgomery's famous tandem wing glider in Santa Clara, California. Nonetheless, in the year following, the Wright brothers decided to patent their newly improved flying machine in May of 1906. Evidence indicates that the Wright brothers were very familiar with Montgomery's research. With this patent came the secrecy and deceit of the Wright brothers as they attempted to secure their own legacy by not mentioning Montgomery and therefore stating that he had no influence upon the original plans of their glider. In a sense, Montgomery Hill stands to signify the common deceptions and inaccuracies that occur in history up until the present. Montgomery was the one who was forced into secrecy when he employed his time and knowledge to build a product of his very own. He was the one who risked his own life every time he decided to test out his gliders, and he was the sole creator behind his revolutionary tandem wings, advanced flight controls, and control surfaces at the rear of his aircraft. Similar to many of history's greatest innovative men and women, John Montgomery is another victim who had his strenuous work and designs unfairly plagiarized by individuals seeking fame and glory through the use of selfish and dishonest behavior. Due to the plagiarism of Montgomery's work by the Wright brothers, Montgomery is not properly represented in history and is not receiving the true acknowledgments for his contributions. Be that as it may, John Montgomery was also the target of the excessive capitalist behaviors that the United States was built upon. With his newly featured glider, which he named Evergreen, Montgomery made up to 55 glides off of what is now known as Montgomery Hill. Unfortunately, on his final glide in October of 1911, Montgomery crashed and was killed as a protruding bolt entered his head. Shortly after his death, Orville Wright attempted to take even more credit for the aviationary achievements at the time by describing Montgomery's accomplishments as mere plane hobbies, St. Ignatius College Preparatory. Supporters for the Wright brothers continuously published these defamatory statements in the press whenever Montgomery was being honored. By minimizing Montgomery's contribution to aviationary technology, the Wright Company was established in 1909 as a commercial aviation business with the purpose to capitalize on the invention of the airplane and was eventually sold in 1915 for $250,000. Once more, John Montgomery becomes victim to the greedy actions of the Wright brothers. Montgomery was the one to design an aircraft with more control and stability than any aircraft before, and he eventually paid the ultimate price of his own life in testing his final glider. Despite spending his time and life on his work, the Wright brothers talked down his accomplishments in order to protect their patent and gain wealth. It seems evident that the Wright brothers' main goal was to capitalize on the newest aviationary innovation and were unafraid to defame or dismiss other contributors on their journey to wealth. To have Montgomery's knowledge and aerodynamic concepts utilized by the Wright brothers for wealth without even mentioning his name is completely unethical and is what ultimately separates the wealthy Wright brothers from the meager John Montgomery. Looking back at Montgomery Hill and the Winged Monument, it can be easy to simply view them as commemorative tributes to one of aviation's greatest contributors. In spite of that, Montgomery Hill will undoubtedly continue to remind community members of the dishonest mindsets driven by capitalism that resulted in one of aviation's most innovative men becoming almost completely unrecognizable. Throughout most of his life, John Joseph Montgomery lived with relatively minimal fame and wealth compared to the well-known Wright brothers. However, without his contributions to society today, aviationary technology would surely be delayed and the fame of the Wright brothers would not be possible. Many modern airplanes today include a numerous number of Montgomery's initial glider features, including flaps on the wings, tapered wings, and his signature tandem wings. As a resident of Silicon Valley, I previously believed that the area gained its fame from recent technological developments, completely unaware of previous creations. Despite today's Silicon Valley being known for the technological advancements of many notable companies such as Facebook, Apple, and Google, John Montgomery's aeronautical inventions were some of the first technological upbringings of the Bay Area. Montgomery may not be as well known as Apple CEO Tim Cook or Facebook CEO Mark Zuckerberg, but there is no doubt that his findings in aviation are utilized today just as much as any social media or cellular technology.